this weird piece of furniture. It's really weird. Top needs to come off. I unscrewed it. We're gonna replace it with a piece of wood, a real wood. I'm gonna take care of all this damaged stuff. Sand it up, stain it, repaint it. Get all that peeling veneer off. I'm just going to sand these, make sure they look smooth. Since all of it's going to be painted anyways, we don't need the veneer on it. We're just using damp microfiber rags to clean the dust off of this thing. We're using a ready-to-use pure white. Try and do this without priming it, but as you can tell, yellow is coming through the white pretty bad. So we're gonna prime it with some stain blocking primer and then put a couple coats of white on it. very yellow. Lots of yellow and brown coming through. We'll probably do two coats of primer and hope that that helps, and then the paint will cover it all up. We've got three coats of stain blocking primer on this. But look at all that yellow coming through. We're gonna sand it, and we're gonna put a coat of white paint on it and see what it does. If the yellow comes through, we will choose a different color. We made the mistake of not sanding in between each coat of primer, so we had a lot of deep brush stroke marks. Like the white's covering, but we won't know for sure till it dries. top with this before I put another coat of polycrylic on it. Lightly sand. In case you don't know, everything we do on this channel is fairly new to us. It's always kind of a learning experience. And one thing we did on this one is laid the polycrylic on too thick. I believe that's what happened. See, drips, it puddled, and turns yellow. There's a little bit of yellow up there. The legs, it's really bad because it just ran down and puddled. There's a little spot there. Another spot there. So, I have to sand it some more. I'm trying to sand all the yellow off. See, I already started there. You can see that spot. Sand all this yellow off. Try to do the next coat a little bit thinner. Well, it's very difficult to get into these grooves and sand this yellow out. And there's still some yellow up here, even after sanding it. When you get close enough, you can see this stuff. And I'm afraid it's just going to yellow more over time, so it's become a headache. So what we're going to do is sand it all down, scuff up this top coat, and then use, people keep recommending this to me, and they swear by it, so we're going to use chalk style paint. And then instead of putting a water-based top coat on it, like this polycrylic, we're gonna wax it. Let's see how that turns out. All right, got it sanded and wiped off. And hopefully this is the last time we have to paint this thing. We're using Kilz chalk style paint in white. It recommends to use a nylon or polyester brush, and I have a 100% polyester brush right here. Let's give it a go. Let's see if I can show you this. Well, yeah, you can see it. See how yellow the bottom one is? The bottom section is? That's how much it yellowed already. When it's done. It's a much smoother finish. I don't see any yellow coming through right now. Those are gone. Maybe these chalk paint fanatics are on to something, I guess. Well, hopefully this works, because I don't want to repaint this. Let it dry and then attempt a coat of wax for the first time ever. We're using Kilz clear wax It says to rub a thin layer of wax on with a clean, lint-free cloth or brush. I bought these microfiber rags, super soft, at a AutoZone or some store like that. So I'm gonna use that. I don't know how you would apply this with a brush, honestly. That's what I'm gonna do to the whole thing. I'll bring you back when it's done and I'll show you what it looks like. Well, I got the wax on. It was easy enough to apply. It's kinda hard to tell where you've already applied it and where it needed to be applied, but it looks good. Now I just have to buff it with a clean, dry rag. And it's done.